one body and one spirit. One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father
all. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal life to every race and nation by the promised gift of your Holy Spirit. Shed abroad this gift throughout the world by the preaching of the gospel, that it may reach to the ends of the earth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost had come, the disciples were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem, and at this sound the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The word of the Lord. Manifold are your works. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Yonder is the great and wide sea, with its living things too many to number, creatures both small and great. There move the ships, and there is that Leviathan, which you have made for the sport of it. All of them look to you, to give them their food in due season. You give it to them, they gather it. You open your hand, and they are filled with good things. Your face, and they are terrified. You take away their breath, and they die and return to their dust. You send forth your spirit, and they are created, and so you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in all his works. He looks at the earth, and it trembles. He touches the mountains, and they smoke.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live.
May these words of mine please him. I will rejoice in the Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Hallelujah.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. No one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now, there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another faith by the same Spirit. To another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, and to another the working of miracles. To another prophecy, to another the discernment of spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. And all these are activated by the one and same Spirit, who allots to each one individually just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. On the last day of the festival, the great day, while Jesus was standing there, he cried out, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me, and let the one who believes in me drink. As the scripture has said, out of the believer's heart shall flow rivers of living water." Now he said this about the Spirit, which believers in him were to receive, for as yet there was no Spirit, because Jesus was not glorified. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Speak to you in the name of the living God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. I remember my second day at seminary. I went to the actual seminary. The first day was all moving in. Second day I went to seminary and I was standing in front of the admin building, and there were 24 other people who wanted to be priests. 24 other people that thought that God called them to be priests. 24 other people that I could talk to about my journey to seminary, about my journey to the priesthood. And it felt so amazing and wonderful to be surrounded by other weirdos. People who believed that God had called them. And I was so in love with seminary that first year, because I got to go to church with the people that I went to school with, which growing up I didn't get to do that. I went to church in a town that was 20 miles away, which in Indiana is 20 minutes away. But I didn't go to school with any of those people, and I didn't work with the people that I went to church with. But in seminary, we worshiped together, and we studied together, and we worked together, and it was this incredible bond. And it's not like we all got along. We had very different opinions on things. And I remember once, speaking hypothetically, I said in class that communion could be Pepsi and a donut if that's all you had. And a man from Georgia, nearly stood up and I think he was ready to punch me for such heresy, such blasphemy, though. Bread and wine has to be bread and wine. And mine was a desert island scenario. For some reason, you only have Pepsi and donuts. But he and I still came to the same table. And he and I shook hands during peace. And he and I played on the same losing sports team. Intramural sports, the seminary had a team for every sport, and we played primarily fraternities, and we were destroyed every Sunday. We loved it. And after my first year at seminary, I came home, and everybody I talked to, I said, "You need to go to seminary." I was so excited and on fire for seminary. I said, "Even if you don't want a priest, be a priest, you need to go. It's just this life-changing experience." I don't think I got anybody to seminary. But people saw how excited I was about church. And church can be that way. Church should be that way. A place where we come and we can disagree. Where we can sometimes vehemently disagree about things. But still come to the table and put out our hands and receive the same bread, the same Jesus. Drink from the same cup. When we renew our baptismal covenant, we will say that with God's help, that we will seek and serve Christ in all persons, that we will respect the dignity of every human being. We will strive for justice and peace among all people. On this day of Pentecost, this day when we celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit descending upon all of the gathered people, those names weren't put in to foil a reader. Parthians and Medes and troglodytes. Those names were put in so that we would understand that people from all over the empire came to worship, and the Spirit descended upon all those people. The Spirit didn't descend upon somebody worshiping at their kitchen table while they read their coffee and read their scripture, drank their coffee and read their scripture. It didn't descend upon the small group reading the shack. It descended upon all of the gathered people. This is the birthday of the church, and next year we're doing up big. We're going to have a big old cake. We're going to have presents. We'll let the kids blow out the candles. Because COVID will be completely gone by then, right? We're going to have kids blow all over the cake. The words that Paul speaks to the Corinthians, we need to recognize how revolutionary those words are. That there is no longer Jew nor Greek, male nor female, free nor slave. That all are one in Christ. Those words were more revolutionary then, more earth-shattering then than they are now. And now we are so divided. But the idea of being one seems impossible. But here we are one. We celebrate one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all. We celebrate what we have in common, and what we have in common is a God who loves us so much that he sent his son to save us. Sisters and brothers, we have far more in common than we realize. I realize that the internet is a place of contention and ugliness, but it's also a place where I realize that I'm just not as special as I thought. Memes have taught me how we are all basically the same. One of my favorite memes is, if you don't have a favorite burner on the stovetop, are you even alive? The favorite burner, by the way, is the bottom right. That is everybody's favorite burner. The meme that talks about giving children bubbles. The life cycle of bubbles. You buy your children bubbles. They open the bubbles. They blow bubbles for 1 minute. They dump out the bubbles. And they scream for more bubbles. Or the one that talks about group projects. You either love group projects or you hate them. And if you hate them, it's because you're the one that does all the work. Realize just how much we have in common. All the vitriol and all the hate that's spewed on the internet is balanced by all the things that we share in common, all the good that comes from it. We can talk about how we're divided. We can talk about what unites us, what binds us. Brothers and sisters, we have an amazing church. A church that preaches love, that preaches redemption, that preaches grace. And our call is not to save anybody or convert anybody. Thanks be to God. Our call is to invite. Come and see. Come and see this amazing place where you are welcomed regardless of where you're from or who you are or what your last name is. Come to this place where it doesn't matter if you like USC or UCLA, or if none of that matters to you at all and you're from a Big Ten school. A lot of throat clearing. Come to a place where we acknowledge that we are fallen, imperfect, sinful, and where we promise to do better. Come to a place that offers love and refreshment. I know we are afraid of offending people. We don't want to be seen as the churchy person. I say this as the churchy person. have something amazing here. We have a fire, a light we should not be keeping under a basket, under a bushel. And all we're doing is offering the invitation, come and see. And if they say no and give us a dirty look, we've done our job. We can say a prayer. And if they say yes and they don't show up, we've done our job. And we can say a prayer. And if they say yes and they come and they worship, we say welcome to a place where you are loved, where you are wanted, where you matter. The world needs to hear this. We need to share our fire. We need to share our love. And it all starts with an invitation. Come and see. Please stand if you are able. And just a note, we are doing the asperges this morning, which means that I will be flicking water up and down the aisle. If you do not want holy water to hit you, move to that side. If you are all about some holy water hitting you, move to the middle. I know y'all aren't going to. Through the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him to newness of life. I call upon you on this day that we remember God's gift of the Holy Spirit to the church, to renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and all her works and promised to give God faithfully in her holy Catholic Church. Amen. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil? And whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord. Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace among all people? And respect the dignity of every human being. Deliver us, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open our hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill us with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep us in faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach us to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send us into the world and witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring us to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen. Thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it, your Son, Jesus, received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Now bless this water, we pray you, that it may be a sign for us of our baptism in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us remember the waters of our baptism. Brothers and sisters in Christ, may the peace of the Lord be always with you. Greet one another in the name of the Lord.
Please be seated.
All right. First off, I'll go up a little bit so you can see my amazing shoes. I don't know if, so when Pope Benedict, the Pope before Pope Francis, I read that he had special shoes made, communion slippers, handmade by Prada. And I thought, I want those. I don't have the budget that the Pope has. And so I bought machine-made shoes by Puma. And I wear them on Pentecost. And so, happy Pentecost. We are glad that you are with us. If you're with us for the first time, please know that all people are welcome to receive communion. The way we're doing communion now is the Eucharistic minister behind me or behind Celeste has the bread, and I will take a piece of the bread, and I will dip it in the wine and hand it to you. If you are gluten-free, tell us that you are gluten-free. If you don't wish to receive the bread but would like a blessing, cross your arms like this, and I will give you a blessing. If you don't wish to receive the wine, tell me before I intinct, and let me know that. And we believe that Jesus is present in the bread and the wine. This Wednesday is the Antique Show Gala, and if you've not signed up to volunteer, but the Spirit has moved you to volunteer, you should talk to Anna. That's Anna? Or Jamie. Jamie might be outside after church. So there are still spots available, and I've never seen it, but I'm told that it's quite the thing. And then the Antique Show is Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. I think that's all I have. Are there any other announcements at this time? Right. Before we, hello Facebook, and before we do the birthday prayer, I want to say a prayer for all those who gave their lives in service. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Lord God, help us to remember all those who gave their lives in service to their friends, to their family, all those who selflessly gave of their entire being. Your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, has taught us that there is no love greater than this than to lay down one's life for one's friends. Help us, Lord, to achieve your vision of us beating swords into plowshares. Help us to pray for peace, and until such time, help us to honor the fallen. I pray this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Is there anybody celebrating a birthday or an anniversary between now and next Sunday? Please come forward. All right. Anniversary? 29. All right. Yes.
Okay. All right. We have a birthday.
And a birthday. All right.
Wait a minute. Pentecost, 13 years ago,
I had the great privilege and great humbleness to become a deacon in the Episcopal Church.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Glad you are a deacon.
Me too.
Right. The prayer is on page 8. Let us pray. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. May the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be now and always. Amen. Celeste, I thank you for all that you are and all that you do, for your friends, your family, your community, your church. May God bless and keep you this moment. May the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and always. May God continue to strengthen and guide your marriage, to surround you in love. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Happy anniversary. Happy birthday. Let us walk in love. Christ loves us. Bring offerings of praise and thanksgivings to his people. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
We praise you and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of life abundant. From before time you made ready the creation. Spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being. Sun, moon, and stars, earth, winds, and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your ways. We rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again, you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day, we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we sing. The riches of your grace, we look with favor upon Mary, your willing servant, that she might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God. Living among us, Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick, and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearned to draw all the world to himself, yet we were heedless this call to walk in love. Then the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it, and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again he gave thanks to you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Now gathered at your table, God of all creation, and remembering Christ crucified and risen, who was and is to come, we offer to you our gifts of bread and wine, and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the body and blood of Christ. Breathe your Spirit over the whole earth and make us your new creation, the body of Christ given for the world you have made. In the fullness of time, bring us with Saint Francis and all your saints from every tribe and language and people and nation to feast at the banquet prepared from the foundation of the world. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever. Amen. now as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. These are the gifts of God for the people of God, holy gifts for holy people. Christ. God of abundance, you have fed us with bread, life, and cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ and one another, and you have made us one, all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world, continue forever, in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. May God, who sent the Holy Spirit as a flame of fire that rested upon the heads of the disciples by pouring out upon them the Holy Spirit, make you rich to his blessing, that you may abound more and more in that Spirit forever. May the blessing of God Almighty, our Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, leave you now and always. Amen.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.